हेलो क्लास फाइव, हाउ आर यू ऑल चिल्ड्रन। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन एडजेक्टिव्स एंड इट्स काइंड्स, एंड टुडे वी विल बी डूइंग द डिफरेंट डिग्रीज ऑफ कंपैरिजन। वी यूज एडजेक्टिव्स व्हेन वी आर डिस्क्राइबिंग अ सिंगुलर नाउन। ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल अ टॉल ट्री, अ ब्लैक डॉग, अ फैट कैट, अ लेजी डोंकी। Sometimes we describe plural nouns also, for example, shiny stars, busy people, or beautiful dishes, tasty dishes. So when we are describing singular noun or plural nouns, we use adjectives, we use these kinds of adjectives. But sometimes while describing, we are comparing also. So when we compare two people, or when we compare more than one person, then different words are used. The adjectives like fat, tall, big, small cannot be used when we are comparing two people or more than one person, or when we have to choose who is the best or who is of the topmost quality. So when we are doing comparison of more than one person, or when we are comparing two people, different adjectives are used. So those are called adjectives of comparison. So on the basis of this, there are three degrees of comparison. Depending upon whether we are describing one noun, or we are making comparisons between two nouns, or we are comparing more than one person, there are three degrees of comparison. The first degree of comparison is positive degree. Positive degrees basically are the different adjectives which we have just done in the previous video, like good, bad, ugly, beautiful, intelligent, slow. Okay, so these, the positive degree is used to describe one noun. Keep that in mind. Okay, the second degree of comparison is comparative degree. Now comparative degree is used when we are comparing two nouns, only two nouns. When we have to make comparison between two people, two things, two animals, birds, or any noun which are two in numbers, if we have to make comparison between two nouns, then we use comparative degree. Okay, and the third degree of comparison is the superlative degree. Superlative degree is used when we have to choose from among four people, five people, or three people. When we are doing comparison, or when we are comparing a noun which are more than two, that more can be 2, 3, 5, 10, 100, thousands, any number of. Okay, so then we use the superlative degree of comparison. Okay, let's see few examples. Okay, now the first example, Raj is an honest boy. Now the sentence is about how many nouns? One noun. The sentence is about Raj, only Raj, and the sentence is telling that Raj is an honest boy. The sentence is telling you about one person only. Okay, so here honest is the positive adjective. Next, or you can say a simple adjective. Next, peacock is a beautiful bird. Now the second sentence is again telling you about one bird only, and that bird is peacock. And what is it telling you about the bird? That peacock is a beautiful bird. So here also the word beautiful is of positive degree. Why? Because Raj is only one boy in this sentence. The sentence is only about one boy, and the second sentence is also about one bird only. So when the sentence is about single noun only, then we use the positive degree of comparison. Okay. Now when you are using the positive degree of comparison, you have to follow the rules of articles also. All in all, how many articles are there? 3 articles, right? A, an, and the. And since kindergarten, you have been told that words which begin with a consonant sound have A before them, and words which begin with a vowel sound have an before them. Okay. Now, if you look at both these sentences, both the sentences are about singular nouns. Okay. In one sentence, an is used before honest, and in the second sentence, a is used before beautiful. Okay. So, here in this sentence, you have to just identify the adjective. But when it comes to fill an adjective, like in the third and fourth sentence. Now, again in the third sentence and the fourth sentence, I have left the portion of adjective blank. Okay. Now, you are supposed to fill a positive degree of adjective here. But you cannot use any adjective here. When you are using a positive degree of comparison, you have to keep in mind whether there's a or an used in the sentence. Why? Because here you will apply the rule which is to be followed with articles. Okay. Now the third sentence is she has a dash habit. Now because here you have to use positive degree. Okay, that is for sure. But which word you will use? Because before the blank there is article A used, then you will be using a word which begins with a consonant sound. Okay, that means you can say she has a bad habit, she has a good habit, she has a strange habit. So many words can come. You know, you can say she has a good habit, or she has a bad habit, or she has a strange habit. All three words are of positive degree. These three words can be used here because every word is beginning with a consonant sound. Good. The first sound that comes of good is G. G is a consonant sound. Bad. B. B is a consonant sound. And strange. S. S is also a consonant sound. So, when you are using a positive degree, keep in mind, I'm only talking about positive degree. This rule you have to use while using positive degree. You have to be very careful about it. Okay. If you'll use any other word, any word which begins with a consonant sound with a, your answer will be wrong. It will be incorrect because you are not following the rules of grammar. When you are doing grammar portion, it has to be very specific. It has to be according to the rules of grammar. You cannot do your own thing in that. So when you are using a positive degree, then you have to keep in mind about these two articles, whether it's an A or an. Because with positive degree, we use these articles. Sometimes A, sometimes an. So the word of positive degree, the word in positive degree will also be according to the rule that is to be followed with this. Okay. So here you can use she has a good habit, she has a bad habit, she has a strange habit. So any three word can be used. If you can think of some other word which begins with a consonant sound and it gives a meaning with habit, then you can use it. Okay. Now comes the second part. Fourth sentence. It was an dash day. Now an is to be followed by a positive degree which begins with a vowel sound, because an is always used with words having vowel sound. Okay. So what we can write here is it was an. Vowel sounds are A, E, I, O, U, A, O, O, O. Okay. A, O, O, O. So these sounds are vowel sounds. So any word which begins with these sounds, mind it, not letter. Not letter, because here if you will see, honest begins with a H. H is her. H makes a sound of her. But we don't say it honest. Do we call it honest? No. We say honest because H is silent. So though this word begins with H, the first sound that is that comes out of a mouth is of O, and that is why an is used. Similarly, we will write a word here which begins with the vowel sound. For example, it was an, you can write uneventful day. Or you can also write it was an eventful day. You cannot say it was an dull day. It was an busy day. You cannot say, because busy and dull are starting with the sound b and d, which are consonant sound. So when it is positive degree, before writing the answer, always look at the article which is used before the blank. If it is an a, if a a is written, then the word should begin with a consonant sound. If it is an, then the positive degree has to begin with a vowel sound. Okay, so this point you must remember when you are using a positive degree. Why? Because sometimes what happens, people write any word of positive degree in the blank without paying attention to these two articles. And it is high time that you start paying attention to these small, small details of the sentence when you are doing the grammar portion. Okay? Next example. My room is bigger than yours. Now, if you read this sentence carefully, you are talking about your room and you are comparing your room with somebody else. So because you are talking about rooms, two different rooms, then because you are making comparison between two rooms, then you have to use comparative degree of comparison. Okay, so here the comparative degree which is used is bigger. My room is bigger than yours. Okay, so here bigger is the comparative degree of which word, which adjective? Big. Big is an adjective. My room is big. If you are saying my room is big, you are telling only about your room. But when you are comparing your room with somebody else's room, then you say my room is bigger than yours. Okay, next. Rita's bag is heavier than Shashi's. Again, you are comparing bags of two different people, the weight of the bag of two different people. One is Rita and one is Shashi, and you are saying that Rita's bag is heavier than Shashi's. So the comparative degree used here is heavier. Okay, next. This story is more interesting than the one I read yesterday. Okay, you are talking about stories. Okay, yesterday also you read a story and today also you read a story. And then you are comparing the two stories. The one which you read yesterday with the one you have read today. So, and then you found that the story which you read today is more interesting than the one you read yesterday. So, here the comparative degree is more interesting. Okay, now if you see these three comparative degrees, you see every comparative degree is different. Somewhere it is ending with er, somewhere it is ending with ier, and somewhere neither er is written nor ier is written, but more is written. Okay, so there are different words which have different forms of comparative degree. And that depends upon whether it can be added, whether er or ist can be added to it or not. If there are certain words in which we cannot use these ier and er as a suffix, so what we do is when such words are there, we use more for comparative degree. And one more thing you have to remember, when we are using a comparative degree, when we are using a comparative degree, the comparative degree is always followed by the word than. Sometimes people get confused which degree to use. which degree to use? Should I use a positive degree, or should I use a comparative degree, or should I use a superlative degree? Don't get confused. Very simple tip. If in a sentence THA and than is used, that means you have to use a comparative degree in the blank portion. That's a tip, so that you do not make a mistake. Simple. If in a sentence A or an is used, then we have to use a positive degree. But if in a sentence than word is used, then in that sentence a comparative degree has to be used. Keep that in mind. It's a very for sure way of not making mistake when you are using any of the three degrees of comparison. So these small points you have to remember, and with practice you will understand, and it will, you know, get imprinted on your mind that with positive degree we use a and with comparative degree we use than. Okay, eighth one is, he is the tallest boy in the class. The sentence is talking about the height of a boy, because he is here written, he stands for masculine gender, singular form. Okay, so because the sentence is talking about a boy's height, when compared to the height of all the other boys in the class, the sentence is saying he is the tallest boy in the class. Among all the boys, suppose if there are 10 boys, out of all 10 boys, he is the tallest one. No other boy is as tall as him, or no other boy is taller than him. So here, that means he is the tallest boy in the class. Okay, next, this doll is the most expensive one. You went to a shop, you asked the shopkeeper to show you different kinds of dolls, and then you liked one doll and you picked it out, and the shopkeeper tells you that among all the dolls, of all the dolls, the doll which you chose is the most expensive one, or in other words, is the costliest one. No other doll cost as much as the one that you have chosen. So here the superlative degree is used, and that superlative degree is most expensive. In the first sentence, tallest is the superlative degree of tall. Okay, so tall is an adjective, taller will be the comparative degree, and tallest is the superlative degree. Okay, next, last example. Today is the happiest day of my life. Something very exciting happened, which was unexpected, and you felt very happy, beyond expectation. And then when you are so full of excitement, you are so happy that you want to say, okay, till now I was not so happy, but today is the happiest day of my life. All the days which you have lived till today, this one is the happiest one. So here the superlative degree is happiest, and it is the superlative degree of which word? Happy. So always remember, when you are learning the three degrees of comparison, keep your three degrees on your three fingers: positive degree, comparative degree, superlative degree, or the other way around: positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree. The index finger will be for positive degree, the middle finger will be for comparative degree, and the ring finger will be for superlative degree. So when you are learning the degrees of comparison, always say like tall, taller, tallest. Tall, positive degree. Taller, comparative degree. Tallest, superlative degree. So give positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree name to these three fingers of your hand. And when you are learning them, you are learning like tall, taller, tallest. Big, bigger, biggest. Small, smaller, smallest. tiny, tinier, tiniest. So the moment you open the index finger, you are saying the positive degree. When you are opening the middle finger, the second finger, you are telling the comparative degree. And when you are opening the third finger, then you are telling the superlative degree. So that's the way of, you know, relating your fingers with the degrees of comparison. So that is one way of learning the different degrees of comparison. Okay. So the superlative degrees are formed by adding ST, EST or IEST after certain adjectives. And when these two words cannot be, letters cannot be added, then you use most with the adjective, like most intelligent, most beautiful, most expensive, most unique. Okay, so there are certain words with which you cannot use ER, EST or IER and IEST. So with those words, when you are using comparative degree, you have to use them with comparative degree. She is an intelligent girl. Intelligent is positive degree. She is more intelligent than her brother. You are using a comparative degree because more is used here. And plus, than is also there in the sentence. And when you say she is the most intelligent girl in the class, yeah, she is the most intelligent girl of all. That means whoever are there, whoever, how many girls are there, she is the most intelligent one. So comparative degree you can form by adding ER or by using more with the adjective. If you are using a superlative degree, you can add IER or IER for comparative degree and IEST for superlative degree. If you cannot use IEST, then you can use most with the adjective.